What space nerd doesn't love watching a Saturn V rise on a column of flame on its way to taking men to the moon, and then also watch it fall apart as it reaches orbit? We're talking stage separation today on Vintage Space. The Saturn V rocket was a three-stage rocket. The first stage, called the S1, was the stage that got the entire stack up off the launch pad in the first place. The second stage, called the S2, gave the payload a bit of a boost about halfway to orbit. The third stage, called the S4B stage, was the stage that got the spacecraft into its final parking orbit around the Earth and also lit a second time on the translunar injection burn, the burn that actually launched the crew in their spacecraft from the Earth to the moon. So why was it a three-stage rocket? Well, there are very few rockets that don't have multiple stages. That's because it takes a lot of fuel to get anything up off the ground, and the heavier the payload, the more fuel you need. The more fuel you need, the heavier it weighs, the more fuel you need, and it becomes a bit of a cycle. Having a staged rocket means that as you're ascending, you can lose part of that rocket, you can jettison it, and what you're putting into orbit becomes lighter and lighter. That's the theory behind a multi-stage rocket like the Saturn V. But how did these stages actually separate? Turns out it was a very intricate dance between explosive detonations, retro rockets, ullage motors, and all guided by an instrument unit. The S1 stage started the entire Apollo stack leaving the Earth. It burned through 203,000 gallons of kerosene and 331,000 gallons of liquid oxygen in a matter of minutes. About 135.5 seconds after launch, a signal sent from the instrument unit shuts down the center of the five F1 engines that powers the first stage. After that point, the four outboard engines continue burning until they have absolutely no liquid oxygen or fuel left. The computer sends an electric signal to the exploding bridgework firing unit around the aft skirt of the first stage that connects it to the second stage. This separates the two stages. At the same time, eight retro rockets on the top of the first stage fire to slow that stage slightly so that it gains some distance from the second stage as it begins to fire. At the same time as the retro rockets started to slow the S1 stage, ullage motors on the S2 stage started firing it forward just a little bit. This wasn't a significant increase in velocity, but it was enough to just increase the separation between the two stages and also force the fuel into the feed lines so that the engines would start burning cleanly. About 30 seconds after stage separation, the aft inner stage separates by explosive charges. It was designed to fall away without hitting the engines that had to fire and had just 3 feet of clearance. Then the five J2 engines powering the second stage fired for about 6 minutes. The second stage burned until about 605,000 feet. About 10 seconds before the second stage propellant was depleted, a signal in the separation system severed the second stage from the third. The inner stage connecting the second and third stages had retro rockets to fire to decelerate the second stage, again ensuring clean separation and a bit of distance between the now spent stage and the stage that had to fire. And again, this stage separation consisted of severable tension straps, fuses, and exploding bridge wire. And like on the second stage, small ullage motors on the third stage helped it gain more distance from the spent stage. So the timing and placement of these devices was extremely precise, but the method was quite simple. Explosive charges would separate the two stages, retro rockets would slow the falling stage to give it some distance, and ullage motors would propel the next stage up a little bit more to gain that distance. Then the next stage engines had to fire, and it was all controlled by the Saturn V's instrument unit. So that's the short answer of how the Saturn V reached orbit in stages. If you want more information, including more detail on the stages and actual altitudes of engine cutoffs, be sure to check out my latest blog post at Vintage Space over on Popular Science. I've got loads more information there. So I want to hear from any amateur rocket groups out there. How do you launch multi-stage rockets? Do you launch multi-stage rockets? Let me know in the comments below, and everyone else, leave me your questions, comments, and ideas for things that you would like to see covered in future episodes. Be sure to follow me on Twitter for daily vintage-based content, and with new videos going up every Friday and occasionally a bonus episode on Tuesdays, subscribe right here so you never miss an episode.